The 8-horsepower billy goat blower project is taking shape, and I've used the machine, and I'm quite happy with the operation. I swear to God, it'll blow a bowling ball across the yard. I had to incorporate a temporary stop switch because this engine did not have the stop switch down on the throttle plate, since this was a replacement engine. So after poking around, there's a couple different models of that. I did finally get the right one. I've also got the wrong one. I'm gonna snap that in today, and then when I run the throttle control to stop position, it'll short the engine and shut it off. The wire's down there someplace. I think I tucked it up out of the way. So not a big deal to put that in, and a couple adjustments so the throttle works properly. A little more cleanup work to do to it, but I'm very happy with the machine. My overall investment is very little money, and although the engine has a little bit of rust and corrosion on it from being in the moisture before I got it, that engine was in fine shape. I took it apart a few weeks back, and I'm glad I did, because there was a fair amount of debris up around the fins on the inside, which certainly would have shortened the life of it. And at the same time, typically on a Briggs, behind the recoil is that square shaft that works with the starter clutch assembly with the little balls in there. Well, that half-inch shaft that thing rides on does require a drop of oil occasionally, especially if the engine's been exposed to moisture. So now the recoil works properly like it should. I'll probably go ahead and put a fresh rope on it because it's got some wear, but overall, it's in nice shape and it runs well. That's what that little stop switch actually looks like. If you're working on one of these engines, be advised there are two of these and they look very similar except for right there. So don't buy them by appearance. Be sure you get the correct part number. That's the one that's used on an 8-horsepower horizontal engine, or anything else that has this same general updraft carburetor and that throttle plate down there. And there's where that thing snaps in place. So now when you work the throttle, you can see at the off position, it shorts right there. So now I have to figure out where the wire is. I swore when I had the blower housing off, I had a ignition kill wire on this engine someplace. There it is. Nope. That's it. I think that's it. Must be. Well, we'll find out. Well, I'm a dummy. There's the terminal right there. I forgot I had done all that. There you can see the wire is already connected down below there with the lug on it. So all I gotta do is put a little jumper wire from this terminal right here over to my stop switch. So a little piece of light gauge stranded wire will do the trick real nice. Put in place, start it up, and make sure the switch works. First things first, let's make sure it's still got oil in it. And it was fine last year, but I've used it. And it works kind of hard. Let's see, I don't see it. Now it's down a tad. All right, yeah, this engine, it's working pretty hard running this blower. So you actually cannot overspeed this thing, although I don't run it with the throttle wide open. I make sure the governor pulls the throttle plate back slightly. There's enough oil in it to start it. Before I go out and use it, I will top that thing off. All right, put some gas in it, see if it's gonna run. I know how to have a good time when it's getting cold outside. Let me show you. Wing leaves.